can draw equally divide. Okay, 7 parts, 7 upon 7. See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 parts, see. So, this part is 1 upon 7. This part is 2 upon 7. This part is 3 upon 7. This part is 4 upon 7. This part is 5 upon 7. And this part is 6 upon 7. And this part is 7 upon 7. So 7 upon 7 means only 1. 7 upon 7 means only 1. So 5 upon 7 is the smaller than 1. 5 upon 7 is the smaller than 1. So where is the 5 upon 7? Here. So for this we have to give the name P. Represent 5 upon 7 on a number line. So P represent 5 upon 7 on a number line. So how to represent 5 upon 7 on a number line in this rule? See, denominator 7. So make the equal parts from 0 to 1, 7 equal parts we have to make. From 0 to 1, in that 7 equal parts we have to make, and then we can show the 5 upon 7 on the number line. Let's learn now types of fraction. Proper fraction. What is proper fraction? Numerator is smaller than denominator, that fraction is called proper fraction. See, now examples for proper fraction I will give. Suppose 4 upon 7, 8 upon 9, 6 upon 15, 12 upon 19. These are the examples of proper fraction. These are the example of proper fraction. What you observe in these? Why these fractions are called proper fraction? Because its numerator is smaller than denominator. If the numerator is smaller than denominator, that fraction is called proper fraction. If the numerator is smaller than denominator, that fraction is called proper fraction. Okay, now if you will see, always proper fractions are less than 1. Proper fraction is less than 1. All proper fraction have value less than 1. These all the fractions are less than 1. Okay, now improper fraction. What is improper fraction? Improper fraction, numerator is greater than denominator. In improper fraction, suppose now 12 upon 5, 13 upon 6, 18 upon 4. See, these all the fractions are improper fraction. Why? Because its numerator is greater than denominator. Its denominator is smaller than numerator. Its numerator is greater than denominator. So these fractions are called improper fraction. These all the fractions are improper fraction. Why these all the fractions are improper fraction? Because its numerator is greater than denominator. If you will see, 12 is greater than 5. The numerator is greater than denominator. That fractions are called improper fractions. So what is mixed fraction? See, these fractions are mixed fraction. A fraction which is combination of whole number and proper fraction. What is mixed fraction? A fraction which is combination of whole number and proper fraction. See, 2 is whole number and this is proper fraction. 1 is whole number and this is proper fraction. So this fraction is called mixed fraction. A fraction which is combination of whole number and proper fraction is called mixed fraction. Let's solve conversion of improper fraction to mixed fraction. Conversion of improper fraction to mixed fraction. Everyone, let's start chapter number 5, fractions. Representation of fractions on a number line. representation of fractions on a number line. Now example 1, represent 5 upon 7 on number line. What we have to represent on number line? 5 upon 7 we are going to represent on a number line. Okay, now see, 5 upon 7 we are going to represent on a number line. See, first draw the number line. Draw the number line, represent 0 here. Okay, 0. And so represent 1 here. Okay, represent 1 here. Okay, and you can represent 2 also here. You can extend the line and you can draw here. You can write here 2 also. Okay, now represent 5 upon 7 on a number line. 5 upon 7 is smaller than 1. 5 upon 7 is smaller than 1. You will say, madam, how 5 upon 7 is smaller than 1? See, this fraction is given 5 upon 7. We have to show on the number line. But it is, I am telling it is smaller than 1. This is smaller than 1. Why smaller than 1? 1 means what? Whole. See, here how many parts are there? 7. 7 parts are there. Total parts are 7. And in that these are the 5. So 1 is greater. So, see, 1 means what? 7 upon 7 means 1. 7 upon 7 means 1. See, 7 1 is 7, 7 1 is 7. If you will do the reduce sum, you will get here 1 answer. 7 upon 7 means only whole. Whole means 1. Okay. So 5 upon 7 and 7 upon 7. In that, see, which is smaller? 5 upon 7. 5 upon 7 is the smaller. Means 5 upon 7 is smaller than 1. How it can 1 understood? If you will do the reduce sum, you are going to get here 1. Okay, so 5 upon 7 is smaller than 1. Means, see, I have represented 0 here, 1 is here. So where the 5 upon 7 will come? Between 0 and 1. Now see, example, express 29 upon 6 as a mixed fraction. Express 29 upon 6 as a mixed fraction. Now what we can do is 29 upon 6 means 29 divided by 6. So divide for 29 by 6. 29 divided by 6. Okay. This we have to convert in the mixed fraction. Now this is improper fraction. 29 upon 6 is improper fraction. Why it is improper fraction? Because its numerator is greater than denominator. So this fraction is called improper fraction, and improper fraction we are going to convert in the mixed fraction. So what will we divide for 29 by 6? 6 4s are 24. Okay, so 9 minus 4, 5, 2 minus 2, 0. So now how to convert these denominator 6 as it is, we have to write. See, this we got. What we got? Quotient that we have to write here as a whole number part. Okay. Remainder we have to write as a numerator. And remainder we have to write as a numerator. See, 6 as it is denominator. 4 we got quotient that we have to write as a whole number part. This is whole part. And remainder which we got 5 that we have to write up for the numerator. Okay, understood everyone? See, this is our 4 is our whole number part. See, 4 which we got the question, that is whole part. This is 6 as a denominator and remainder we have to write as a numerator. So 4 integer, 5 upon 6. Again you can do this. 6 4s are 24. 24 plus 5, 29. 29 upon 6. This way you can read. So after convert understood, you have to divide 29 upon 6. You have to divide this. Then the quotient which you got, that you have to write as a whole number part. And 6 as it is denominator and remainder which you got, that you have to write as a numerator for this. Okay. Let's learn converting mixed fraction into improper fraction. Okay. In that example, see. This is first example, 3 integer 5 upon 7. I have to read this number. 3 integer 5 upon 7. Now this is mixed fraction and we are going to convert in the improper fraction. is mixed fraction, we are going to convert in the improper fraction. So what we are going to do for that? See, whole number part which it is 3. So whole number multiple by denominator, we are going to multiply, okay? And in that plus 5 we are going to do. Add 5 in that means numerator we have to add in that. And write denominator as it is, okay? See which numbers we are going to multiply. 3 into 7 means these into these means whole number and denominator we are going to multiply. And in that we are going to add 5 and write 7 as a denominator as it is. Denominator we have to write as it is. So 3 sevens are 21 plus 5 upon 7. So 21 plus 5, how much we got? 26. Okay, 26 upon 7. So we got now improper fraction. See, 26 upon 7. 26 is numerator and 7 is denominator. Now see, numerator is greater than denominator we got. So we converted mixed fraction into improper fraction. What we have to do in this? See, do the multiplication of whole number into denominator. In that numerator we have to add. As it is denominator we have to write. Okay, so 3 sevens are 21 plus 5. And denominator as it is 7. 21 plus 5, 26 upon 7. Same way now here also we are going to do what I said. What we are going to do for this? 4 multiple by 7. Whole number it is 4. 4 multiple by 7. Whole number multiplied by denominator. Okay. Plus, what is in this numerator? It is given 5 upon 7 as it is. Okay. So, 4 sevens are 28 plus 5 upon 7. Now, 28 plus 5. How much it will come? 33. Okay, so 33 upon 7. So we got improper fraction. What we did? 4 multiple by 7 plus 5. Or you can do this also. 7 multiple by 4 and in that you have to add 5. 7 4s are 28. 28 plus 5, 33. Very easily. And denominator we have to write as it is. Orally also we can do. No need to write this all the process. See, if you understand easiest way, no need to write this all the steps for these, at least for these. 7 4s are 28, 28 plus 5, 33. Understood how to convert mixed fraction in the improper fraction? 7 4s are 28, 28 plus 5, 33. So 33 upon 7 is the improper fraction. Let's now practice 5.2. Draw a number line and locate points on them. Draw a number line and locate points on them. Now see, here 1 upon 7, 2 upon 7, 3 upon 7 and 4 upon 7. So total parts how much? 7. Denominator see, everywhere it is 7. So draw a number line. Locate the point 0. Okay, 0 here. Then how many equal parts we are going to do? 7. See, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yes, denominator is 7. So for this number line, I give 7 parts. 7 parts means it is 1. 7 parts means it is 7 upon 7 means whole. So 0 to 1. This is 0 to 1. Okay. See, 0 I will write here. 0 to 1. Why 0 to 1 I have written here? See, 1. How many total parts are there? 7. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 parts. 7 part means 7 upon 7. 7 upon 7 means only 1. Now what we have to show on the number line 1 upon 7? So this part is 1 upon 7, 2 upon 7, 3 upon 7 and 4 upon 7. Here no need to show, only this much it is a sum. Represent only that much points on them. Okay? Draw a number line and locate points on them. See, this point is 1 upon 7. This is 2 upon 7, 3 upon 7 and 4 upon 7. See, this part is 5 upon 7, this is 6 upon 7, this is 7 upon 7. 7 upon 7 means 4, means 1 it is. Okay. Now again, now see in this question, total parts are 9. See, 2 upon 9, 4 upon 9, 5 upon 9 and 9 upon 9. So first represent here 0. Okay. How many total parts you have to make? 9. Okay. 1. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So 9 part is whole. 9 part is whole means 9 upon 9. Okay. Now show here 2 upon 9. See now it is here 0. Means first part is 1 upon 9. So this part is 2 upon 9. This part is 3 upon 9. So where is 4 upon 9? This part is 4 upon 9. Then next part is, this part is 5 upon 9. Okay. Then this part is 6 upon 9, 7 upon 9, 8 upon 9 and this part is 9 upon 9. 9 upon 9 means only whole. 1. Yes. 9 upon 9 means only 1. Yes. So which points it has asked? That only points we have to show on the number line. 2 upon 9. See, this is 0. First we have to represent 0, then make 9 equal parts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 means all equal parts. Okay, we did. Okay, 9 means 9 upon 9 means whole. Okay, means 1. Okay, so 1 upon 9. This part is 1 upon 9. This part is 2 upon 9. This part is 3 upon 9. This is 4 upon 9. 5 upon 9, 6 upon 9, 7 upon 9, 8 upon 9 and 9 upon 9. But only which we have to show here, these which are given in the question. That only points we have to show on the number line. So question number 2, from the fractions given below, separate proper fractions. We have to separate proper fraction. What is proper fraction? If the numerator is smaller than denominator, that fraction is proper fraction. When the numerator is smaller than denominator, that fraction is proper fraction. Now see, first fraction. See here, I'm writing proper fraction. Five upon 17. This is proper fraction or not? Yes, because see, 5 is smaller than 17. So this fraction is proper fraction. Then 11 upon 7, is it proper fraction or not? Is it proper fraction? No, see, numerator is greater than denominator. This fraction is improper fraction, so don't write here. 3 upon 8, 3, see, numerator is smaller than denominator. 3 is smaller than 8, so this fraction is proper fraction, 3 upon 8. Then see, 9 upon 7. 9 upon 7, see, numerator is greater than denominator. So this is improper fraction. So don't write here, see, this is also not proper fraction. Only we have to write here proper fraction. So these are not proper fraction. 11 upon 14, see, 11 is smaller than denominator. 11 is smaller than 14. So this is proper fraction, 11 upon 14. Then 7 upon 6. 7 is greater than 6, means numerator is greater than denominator. So this is improper fraction. So this is not proper fraction. Then 5 upon 8. See, 5 is smaller than denominator. 5 is smaller than 8, means numerator is smaller than denominator. So 5 upon 8 is proper fraction. Then 3 upon 15. 3 upon 15 also proper fraction. Why? Because see, 3 is smaller than 15, means numerator is smaller than denominator. So this fraction is proper fraction. Then 25 upon 9. 25 upon 9, it is improper fraction. Why? Because see, numerator is greater than denominator. So this is not proper fraction. This is improper fraction. Then 13 upon 10. 13 upon 10, if you will observe, this is also improper fraction. See, numerator is greater than denominator. So this is also improper fraction. This is not proper fraction. So 18 upon 17. See, 18 is greater than 17, means numerator is greater than denominator. So this is also improper fraction is, this is not proper fraction. Then 18 upon 19 is proper fraction because numerator is smaller than denominator. See, 18 is smaller than 19, so numerator is smaller than denominator, so this is proper fraction. Then 21 upon 37 also proper fraction. 21 is smaller than 37. Okay, means numerator is smaller than denominator, so proper fraction. Then 15 upon 16 also proper fraction because 15 is smaller than 16, so this fraction is proper fraction. 15 upon 16 means 15 is smaller than 16, so this is proper fraction. Let's solve question number 3. Write 5 proper fractions. We have to write any 5 proper fractions whose numerator and denominator differ by 3. Whose numerator and denominator differ by 3. This answer everyone's, it can come different. This, for this means whatever I am showing, that is only correct answer. It is not like that. That is correct, but your numbers, it may come different also. Okay, differ by 3 means in numerator and denominator numbers, it should be the difference 3. And what we have to write proper fraction. Suppose if I will write, take here 5 as a numerator. 5 as a numerator. So what will be the denominator? 8. What it is given, right? 5 proper fraction whose numerator and denominator differ by 3. This difference is 3. Proper fraction I have written here. Numerator is smaller than denominator. So this is proper fraction. And see, if you will find the difference. 8 minus 5, 3. It should be differ by 3. It should be differ by 3. See, if you will find the difference. 8 minus 5, 3. 3 you are getting. So what you do? Whatever numerator you will take, in that add 3. So you will get the denominator. So, okay, now next what I will do? 6. Suppose next I have to 6. In 6, if I will add 3, I will get denominator 9 and it is proper fraction. So 9 minus 6, 3. Denominator, see, right? 5 proper fraction whose numerator and denominator differ by 3. Now see, numerator and denominator, its difference you will find. See, 9 minus 6, how much it we are getting difference? 3. Differ by 3. So such numbers you have to write. So you can write your own numbers also. Just I will show any 5. You can do your own number also. You can prepare your own numbers also. But it should be the proper fraction, not improper fraction. See, suppose next number I took 7. What will be the denominator? 10. 7 plus 3, 10. Why I am adding plus? Because difference we have to show 3, na? So 10 minus 7, 3 we are getting. What we are getting? 10 minus 7, 3. Difference we are getting 3. Difference between 7 and 10. How much differ it is? 3. Okay. So next fraction, suppose I took 8. So what is the denominator? 11. What is the denominator? 11. 11 minus 8, 3. Okay. Then suppose now next I took 9. So denominator will come 12. Understood this question? Very easy question. You can write your own fractions. Okay. It is not like that. Whatever numbers I have given, that only you have to write. You can write your own numbers also. But the fraction should be proper fraction and whose numerator and denominator it should be differ by 3. If you will observe in my examples, it differ by 3. See, 5 upon 8, 8 minus 5, 3, difference we got 3. 6 upon 9, 9 minus 6, difference 3. 7 upon 10, 10 minus 7, difference we got 3. 8 upon 11, 11 minus 8, 3. Okay, 9 upon 12, 12 minus 9 we got 3, so differ by 3.